So Carrie Underwood came out with a new album September 14th, entitled Cry Pretty, and I need to talk about it. Cannot be more excited, cannot be more thrilled to like use my degree, my communication skills to talk about something I can always talk about for a very long time. So I have loved country music for a long time. I have loved her and her music for a very long time. So this is one of the best reviews I could ever be doing, even as I'm starting and want to go further with. With that said, we're going to hop right into her album. Her album actually is a really important thing to talk about because her last album was Storyteller, which was released to us, the public, in 2017. So we've been waiting almost 2.5 to 3 years for some great new music for her. And in that time, a lot has happened to her, tragically, sadly, but she's able to still be optimistic, and as she says, they have happened for a reason, and she's going to find the bright side to them. So that's really good, and I have been trying to do the same thing, and it's pretty much all led her to this point here, where she now has a new album out, and she's expecting her second child. So, congratulations. But our anticipation is now gone because we can now buy, download, listen, and I mean, the album is all there for us to have, so we get that chance. And talking about the album inside of it now, I've been listening to it, I think, 4 times now, just to understand it, to feel it, to understand everything that she has put into the album. Because after all, she has written, I want to say, 90% of the songs. She was a producer, and she was there to from the beginning to the end. So she has a lot to do of this album, and quote-unquote, what she said in an interview, she believes that this is like her most personal album that she's ever done yet. So that should be taken not with just so light. That should go like heavy to your heart that she's doing that much work. Also, some of her songs I felt were reminding me of past songs from past albums. There is Something in the Water, Don't Forget to Remember Me, a little bit of Crazy Dreams, So Small, Just a Dream. All of the songs that really were and were not singles that were still highly loved by fans that she still performs today, I feel have a little bit of connection and moment in this new album. And I'm not sure if that was on purpose or not, but it does sound great still, no doubt. With her voice, I'm going to kind of compare it to Storyteller. I felt a lot of her last album was in her lower range and tone, and this one went up a little bit more, kind of like Play On album. That one had a little bit more of a range that was in the higher part. So for example, you have Relapse, a little bit of Dirty Laundry, you have Clock Don't Stop, and then Chaser, Little Girl Don't Grow Up Too Fast. All of those songs were to me in her low range, and then here we have, she's decided to go up higher and even show us some new moves. I mean, there's some songs that are low and high, of course, but she gives us a soft voice. She gives us not too graspy, it's not twangy like her old album was. It's a new sound, and that is also part of your voice, the sound that you project. So I always, at first, was like, I don't know about this album. Then I was talking about Ghost on the Stereo, and then we're going to third song and fourth song. I think that's like low, and I'm not sure the fourth song in the album by heart yet. but it just kept on fluctuating, like that song, don't like that song, in the middle with that song. And by the fourth time, I'm like warming up to the songs, I'm understanding, hey, this is actually a new album. It's supposed to be new stuff. It's supposed to be a different look from Carrie or a different look just on music. And she was able to do that. I was surprised by a lot of her songs, the way that I thought she was going to take it. She didn't. And I'm like, oh, okay. Kind of surprised vocal right there. Kind of surprised wording right there. She did bring in surprises in this album. Some of them, like I said, with the songs, they sounded like it's been before. They just sound pretty, like, not every other song, but a music that someone could recognize and know. And so that was that part. I also think that because she said this is her personal album, I started thinking about what's personal about it. And then I've heard some of the songs, like I said, I've listened to this at least 4 times. I've heard songs feel like they're coming from her, that they're about her, telling a completely vulnerable side. And I think back to the song Cry Pretty. She says she tries holding her posure, and, you know, she is like celebrity in the camera, so that's who she's always going to be. And then she said that outside the camera, she's Carrie Underwood, she's a human being, she might fall. And I believe with some of these songs, she did that. She stepped out of being on the spotlight, pushed her composure aside, and let herself fall into her music, into her songs, and was being human, like right next to me, right next to you. So that was very, very important, very touching and vulnerability. The biggest song that kind of touched my eye in this example was Kingdom. Sure, can you kind of be taken and implied different ways, but I felt like she was saying where her kingdom is, what is her kingdom. She talks about her family, her job. I also feel like she was talking about her charities, the world, what she loves, and all of that makes her kingdom, and that's where she's going to, you know, reside, and where she's going to continue living and be by their side. That was actually a good song, too. It took a while, and then it only took a while because I had to realize that this was a soft song, a personal story, not just a story or a song. So that one touched my heart a little bit too, because I know she has soft sides for a lot, including military and animals and family. So, you know, she gave it one of those parts to us. And then, besides that song, I said that she gave a little bit to us of her. And I think that's important because that's what we fans want and expect. And our expectations for artists, no matter if they're singers or actors or painters, are always high, because we don't want the same thing, because then we get really bored by it and we move on. We always expect something different, something better, something bigger. And just by giving her more of a Carrie Underwood side from her lifestyle, I definitely think that is bigger, better, and more on a different level. You know, we don't go for those crazy songs that stretch out our voice or try to do something we never done before. She took it to her level where, you know, she's always walking every day in her shoes, really. So, really appreciate that. And I think that's very noble of her, because we don't know Carrie besides what's on social media, which is her as well as her team. So she took that step and followed her beliefs and morals. And I don't think she would not have done that, because we all know that she is a Jesus Christ lover and prays and has strong feelings in a religious way. So I don't think she would go outside that realm and go against that. So I'm really humbled by that, because now I get to see what she thinks and what she truly, truly writes about and what she wants to give us, because there's also artists who don't do that. They'll write songs, but because it comes to their head, they'll also just take songs because it sounds great or because they do actually love it and can find a purpose about it. Not necessarily think about themselves and what their picture and reputation will look like to the fans, or what they want. They don't take that risk sometimes, giving themselves up to show us versus just giving us show, giving us songs, just giving us something to give them money. That was my reaction, my impression. My flaws, I actually kind of already said it, that like I was taken back by the how it kind of had a path to it and then brought into this new album. And I would definitely get the album just so you can understand or see an artist from a different perspective. Because we all know every artist is different, and this is another artist who's showing a different side, showing that what music can do, what writing can do, what performing can do, what following your dreams can really do. So that's my reaction. I've listened to it four. I'll probably listen to it more, you know, until we obviously get them all memorized. Her tour, Cry Pretty 360, starts in 2019, I believe in May, because she's expecting her second child, and she is taking time to be with her family. There we go again, being personal. So go look for that, but she's still on the move. She's still on TV performing her new songs. Love Wins, I believe she was just on Jimmy Fallon. I think it was Jimmy Fallon. Yes, a few days ago in Central Park, and I've heard that it rocked, and that there were crowds of people just waiting to see her. So she's still kicking, she's still rocking, she's still doing what she loves, because she wants to give back, I assume, and give what we want. So thank you for watching this review. Hope you liked it. Like it or dislike it. Write comments if you want to agree. If you want to disagree, go for it. I will not hate you. I'm going to still love you. And also subscribe. Lastly, I have officially joined patreon.com. just find me there and support me, become a patron, and we are going to build ourselves up together like I plan on it. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon. Come back for another edition of music reviews and reactions with Ryan Talks.